give the album deck his ear. I found this meeting extraordinarily interesting so far, so interesting. I've got all the lectures, most of the lectures, and I've had very little time to prepare my own lecture. So I'm sorry if this is not going to have the high technology, but some of my business is there. It's low technology. But I'll try to do my best with some help. Now, I'm going to talk about new ideas in old bottles. And I'm going to focus on some particular aspect. I'm going to talk about one of the oldest numbers in mathematics, pi. You all know what pi is? I hope. Pi, yes, of course. So, pi is the oldest number known in mathematics. It goes back to Archimedes. And I'll show you shortly little history pictures. So, let's go back to the past, and I got these links to the past, to your mind. I have Plato, there's holding up his finger, representing philosophy in the past, and then through the ages, we went through astronomy, geometry, algebra, analysis, to the present time, to the future. In the past, before astronomy, astrology, where people predicted the future by looking at the stars. And Plato, as you see in this picture, you all recognize Plato because he is famous for being in the portrait painted by Raphael, which is in the Vatican. This man with a big beard, you know he's Plato. And on the right hand side, there's a picture of the famous James Clerk Maxwell, the great scientist, philosopher, who without whom he would not be here. He invented the laws of electromagnetic theory of which all modern society rests. So this describes the history of mathematics from the past into the future. And I'm just going to press some buttons now. I think if I press this button. Oh, no, wrong one. Is that right? You should be able to see the Archimedes. Do you see Archimedes? So, of course, you all know what Archimedes looks like. If you want to look at it close up, you only got to work hard to get a field medal. When you get a field medal, you see Archimedes. So, it's very easy to see Archimedes. If you run, you get it working hard. Of course, he looks like what you think Archimedes looks like, because he is obviously a great thinker. That is what we imagine Archimedes looked like. Of course, before him was Pythagoras. We don't know what Pythagoras looked like, but he had a big beard, obviously. And then I've drawn underneath some selected people who are great mathematicians and thinkers. Isaac Newton, that actually portrait was a painting which I had in my own room at Trinity College. There's Leonard Euler, all know about Euler. And there's, of course, the great Gauss. This is a selection of the people who created mathematics for the past. I hope you all recognize them. Now, on stage, can I go to, let's see, the modern technology. Now, let me see if I, what happens if I do this. I hope I've got it. It's a complex path now. Is that right? Yes, okay. So there I'm, okay, this is the Abel lecture. You must see a picture of Abel. There are not very many pictures of Abel. This is a unique one. It's been propagated in many forms. You can buy a Norwegian magnet worth 500 kroner, I think. They said, oh, so it doesn't cost you very much. 500 kroner is not very much. You can get a picture of Abel and you can put it in your room. Then I've got next Abel, I've got the great Hamilton. Hamilton was the great Irish mathematical physicist. He did many things, very famous. And as you see, among other things, he invented the algebra turnings. Then next to him, we have two people with beards. And you had to have beards in those days to be taken seriously. There's Riemann, with a good back beard, and Maxwell, who what I only call enlightened beard, the light of light, the beard that shines with light. Since Maxwell, the person who explained light, which is actually a phenomenon, is very appropriate because the beard looks like that. So these are the great figures of the past, up to the time of Max. And I think at this stage, I should be telling you what I'm going to do with the lecture. My lecture, I said, future, we can think of the past. So first of all, we've got to go to the past. To the past. And the past for me meant Archimedes, Pythagoras, and so on. So I'm going to start with the number pi. I've mentioned pi. Now here, I think I have to get pi up on the screen. My friend here will point a laser at pi. I can't do it from here. Technology is not that advanced. I can't get a reflective laser. But I can point to my friend. You will point the laser. I hope you can see over there. Now, I've got a table in front of me here. So I can tell you this table is where all the mathematics on this talk. And this lecture is going to be, have two parts. A lot of famous people, I'm sure you're famous people, some written ideas. There I have this nitty-gritty, mathematical symbols. Mathematical symbols that encapsulate all the ideas. So this little table is, so to speak, a Rosetta Stone. Every symbol in that has a deep meaning, and I'm going to take you through the meaning. But I'll be kind. I won't give you the whole story. I'll only use a little bit. It's good to see the whole picture. The part I'm going to focus on is pi. There is pi, top row, first number. You see pi. You recognize pi? If you move further along that row, you'll find other numbers. You know what pi is? Well, you know what it is. Ratio of circumference of circle of lambda, but you also know number pi is number. It's 3.14. I don't know how many figures you know, but you can write it all down. The next number after pi there is a number called gamma. This is Euler's constant. Euler had many famous figures and invented numbers. He invented gamma. Gamma is a mysterious number. I'm sure you know, you've heard about gamma. It is a nice value. I think it's about 0.5 something. I don't can't wrestle, but it has a well-defined number, and it's very important. It's one of Euler's creations. After that, there's another famous number invented by Euler. It's called E. I hope you know what E is. It's the basis of natural logarithms. It is 2 point something rather, and it's well known. But more importantly, it is the foundation of the exponential function. These numbers are all very important mathematics. Mathematics couldn't live without these numbers. Pi, gamma, e. So what more do you need? Man lives on a few crumbs of bread. And mathematicians live a few. And on a desert island, all you need is pi, gamma, e. Now, I'm going to talk about this table, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about each letter, each symbol, history, past, and on the right-hand side, on the left-hand side, there are mathematical constants. Pi is a mathematical number, E is a number, these are all numbers. They're beautiful numbers in mathematics. On the right-hand side, I'm going to talk about physics. And physics are also very important numbers, or very important constants. On the top row, I've got C. You all know what C is? It's the velocity of light. What's probably more important than velocity of light? Determines out all our waves. And besides C, there's a number called H. It should have a slash to it. It's called Planck's constant. Well, there are two versions of Planck's constant, H or H divided by 2 pi. This is Planck's constant. Planck's constant is very fundamental to physicists. But the next number is Q of E. Now, E is a common letter. It's the most common letter in the English alphabet. And I think in probably many languages. E is the most common letter, so it's been overused. So E on the left-hand side is Euler's E. E on the right-hand side is the electron. The electron came after Euler, of course. So the E on the left of E on the right-hand side is the weak E. That's the electron. And Q of E is the charge of the electron. So this is a very important quantity, the electron charge. If you're a physicist, you know all this. If you don't, if you're a mathematician, this is your first course of physics. And, well, I want a more